over here at church, and I'm just going to record a few thoughts from Mother's Day. If you're watching this today, then great. If you're watching at another time, that's fine. You can sort of have Mother's Day a bit later if you like. I've got a craft activity for the children, so make sure you get yourself a piece of A4 paper, and you're going to make a crown out of that, so you'll need some things to decorate it with. Also, if you want to, during the prayers, light a candle and maybe get yourself a small candle ready to do that. You can put the video on pause for now while you go get those, and then when you're ready, come back and join us. I thought we'd start off with our messy church song, Welcome Everybody. I'm just going to sing it to you, join in if you want, and we're just going to do the Welcome Everybody bit. Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. Gathering in this place. Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. 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 Gathering in this place. Of course, we can't gather at the minute because of the coronavirus, but we're gathering in spirit at home as you watch it. We're going to start with a bit of quiet. I'm going to light our candles to remind us of God's presence among us. I'm going to light all three candles, our Easter candle from Sunday service, our messy church candle, and our messy munchkins candle. So whichever candle is for you, it's being lit now. Thank you, God, that you are here with us. As we come to God, first let's remember that sometimes there are things that separate us from God. Blindness that stops us from seeing what God really wants us to see. And sometimes that's the best in other people. And at the minute, some people are being very selfish at times, and others are being very generous and giving. Prayer is that we can lean towards the being selfless and giving people. God of grace, forgive the blindness that stops us from seeing the best in people, assuming that we are always right, so others must be wrong. Blindness that sometimes makes us regard some people as inferior, or when we haven't allowed them a point of view because of disability or status. Forgive our blindness to poverty, to prejudice, to injustice. Forgive our blindness when we see people as nobodies. Forgive us, Lord, and open our eyes to wonder and to possibilities, to relationships and to community. Amen. I've been thinking a lot about Esther, and I thought I'd tell you the story of Esther, and we'll do it in an interactive style. So when you hear the word Esther, she was the queen, so I want you to do the queen. When you hear the word Mordecai, he's the kind uncle, so we'll do the kind uncle. And when we hear the word Haman, he's the baddie, so we're all going to go, boo! I'm going to try and remember to do them all, see if maybe I've missed one and you can catch me out. So this is a story about Esther. Esther, the queen, was a star. a beautiful Jewish girl chosen by the king of Persia to be his queen. Esther, the queen, had an uncle called Mordecai, the kind uncle, who was very kind. When Esther, the queen's parents, died, he raised her as his own daughter. And when she was made queen, he warned her not to tell the king that she had come from one of his captive lands. And so the king was clueless. He loved Esther, the queen, but he did not know she was a Jew. Haman, was horrible. He was the king's right-hand man, and he loved nothing as much as pushing people around. One day, Haman, was walking through the city when he met some of the king's other servants. "Bow before me," horrible Haman, commanded, and they bowed, all except for Mordecai, the kind uncle. "I will bow before no one but God," said Mordecai, the kind uncle. Haman was furious. And went straight to the king to seek his revenge. "There's a troublesome race of people in our land," he said, "who worship a different god. They are the Jews, your majesty. Give me your permission, and I will do away with them." He was clueless, so he told horrible Haman, to kill every Jew in the land, not knowing that he was condemning his own queen. When Mordecai, the kind uncle, heard the news, he went to see Esther, the queen. "Go to the king," he said, "and do what you can to save us. But I have to wait for the king to invite me into his presence," Esther, the queen, explained. "If I go to him without his invitation, the law of the Persians say that he has the right to kill me." "You must go anyway," said Mordecai, the kind uncle. "Whatever the risk, God puts people in places at just the right time, so they can do what he wants. God has put you in the palace to save your people." Esther, the queen, was a star. So Esther, the queen, went to see the king. And far from being angry, the king was delighted to see her. "What do you want, my darling?" he asked. "I want to have a dinner party," said Esther, the queen, "and I want you to invite your right-hand man, Haman." The king agreed. The date was set, and horrible Haman, was happy. He'd been building a horrible hanging machine in his garden where he hoped to murder Mordecai, the kind uncle. And the queen's invitation made him happier still. But when he got to the party, horrible Haman, was suddenly not so happy. "I've had some sad news today," said the queen, with tears in her eyes. "Someone wants to see me dead, and not only me, but all of my people too." "Who is this person?" shouted the king. "Tell me, and he will soon be dead instead." "There he is," said Esther, the queen, and she pointed at Haman.
"I don't understand, Haman," trembled. "I've nothing against you."
"Yes, you do," said Esther, the queen, "for I am a Jew. And you mean to kill us all." The king was no longer clueless. He saw everything clearly now. He loved his queen. He did not care that she was a Jew, but he was very angry with Haman. Boo! Put him to death, the king ordered. And so Haman, boo, was hanged on his very own hanging machine. But Esther, the queen, and Mordecai, the kind uncle, and all their people lived on to return to their own land. And all because Esther, the queen, was a star. Maybe you're wondering what you can do during this coronavirus, but maybe a little act of kindness, a telephone call to someone, or maybe delivering some food for someone who's in isolation. All of these things can be really helpful. And perhaps you, like Esther, can be a star. So if you'd like to make a crown, you can see the picture. You take your piece of A4 paper, cut whatever design what you want on. It doesn't have to be little peaks. It can be whatever designs you like. Put it together with a bit of sellotape and make a crown to remember Queen Esther. And maybe you'll decide on who can you present the crown to because they're a star. Maybe on Mother's Day it'll be your mum, but I'm not making any suggestions. It's up to you. So while the children are making that, here's a reading for the grown-ups. This reading comes from Psalm 24. It's one of the royal psalms. It's one of the psalms that were sung as people entered into the temple. It's a psalm attributed to David. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the world and those who live in it. For he has founded it on the seas and established it on the rivers. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and pure hearts, who do not lift up their souls to what is false, and do not swear deceitfully. They will receive blessing from the Lord, and vindication from the God of their salvation. Such is the company of those who seek him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob. Selah, which means pause and think a minute. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Selah. Those words, lift up your gates, open up those ancient doors, were how we started Lent. And here we are, beginning, I suspect, of coronavirus, where we're locked in, isolated, social distancing is the norm. I suspect this will go on for quite a long time. And this psalm reminds us that no matter what, the Lord is the King of glory, strong and mighty. Encourages us to open up the doors. Open up the doors that maybe we've closed in our minds and in our hearts. And perhaps during this strange time, this very unsettling and fearful time, perhaps in opening up our hearts to God, we'll find some strength, some encouragement, some hope. As many of you know, I suffer from depression, and I find myself at times being on the verge of just thinking I can't cope. But just to sit down and remember and to put things into perspective has been extremely helpful. To try and change the way I'm thinking about things has been very useful. To not see it as, oh, we're confined, but rather, here's a chance to spend time either alone or with family. At a time when we maybe want to get out and do things, here's a chance to sit down, reflect, and be quiet. Remember what's important in life. I quite like this psalm because of those words. Who can stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and pure hearts. I can feel my own hands are dry from all the washing. But actually, as we wash our hands, perhaps we can remember to ask God to wash our hearts. Those who do not lift up their souls to what is false and do not swear deceitfully. In other words, those who hold on to what is true. The anchoring truths in your life during this coronavirus. Is it that God is the King of Glory? Is it that Jesus is the hope for us all? Selah. Pause and calmly think of that. Have our prayers now, and I'm going to light a tea light. And if you want to do the same at home, you can do that, or perhaps if you've got one of the electric ones, or just in your mind's eye, light a tea light as a light before God. So let us pray. Light of the world, we pray for those who suffer prejudice because of any kind of disability, physical, emotional, social, or mental. Help those suffering from coronavirus. Help those treating the sick. Give wisdom to those making major decisions at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who work for a fairer and more just society, where all can be free to live, no matter what their circumstances. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who walk in darkness, with no light and little hope. May they know the joy that only you can bring. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal those who mourn, suffering loss and sadness, those who are alone, rejected by family and friends, those who are outcasts in our society. Lord, show us how to be instruments of your healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Amen. We say together the disciples' prayer, also known as the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. finish just a few bits of information. Firstly, the children have made crayons. Take a picture, send it in to me. Either send it to the church email address, minister@stmarkschurch.me.uk, or put it on the Facebook page. Also, if you need any help, if you're self-isolating and you need someone to go shopping for you, again, get in contact, let me know. Make sure you're on the church website, there's lots of information and ideas and things there. Or give me a call on 01737 353 011. And I'll try and coordinate help. If you can offer help, or if you need help, let me know. Let's finish with this blessing. May God bless you and keep you. May God's presence be with you and all whom you love. May God's face shine on you. May God's loving arms surround you and give you peace.